Hallelujah. Praise God, we are back again on this 24th day of this podcast. Thank you for staying in touch. We are entering into very sober parts of this podcast. And we started yesterday talking about why Deborah, why Yahel. And we saw that Yahel and Deborah were used of God to indict the leaders who were purely men as at that time. Women were not reckoned with, but God used those that were not reckoned with to bring massive deliverance to the land after 20 years of what the Bible calls mighty oppression from the hand of Sisera. And I'm saying, if the spirit of Yahel is going to arise in this decade, then that means that we should look out for the same scenario that prevailed then. This scenario that played out, they are coming back again. And I'm saying that we need to take it in order for us, especially those who are leaders, to watch out how we deal with God's people, that we do not use them for our political ends or economic ends or for our own social needs or to meet our own egoistical needs. When we begin to use them, the Bible says we are rubbing their faces on the ground. You are rubbing the faces of the poor on the ground. The poor there does not only mean that they don't have money. It means that they are not as endowed as you are, whether it's in knowledge, whether it's in anointing, whether it's in position, whether it's in authority, whether it's in finances, whatever. You have an advantage over them. And when you begin to treat them with that disrespect, that kind of disrespect, we begin to deal with them without dignity. We need to deal with them without respect. God is saying you are rubbing their faces on the ground, and God is saying you are going to meet me in my court where I'm going to judge. And that's why I'm asking for us to put on sobriety as never before, especially as leaders. Because where did Deborah come? Deborah and Yahel were used of God because the leaders of them, every one of them failed woefully. We read from the book of Isaiah chapter 3. And I would like to read 14 and 15 again. We started from 12. But let me read from 14 and 15 again. The Lord will enter into judgment with the ancients and of his people and the princes. Those are leaders. The princes thereof, for ye have eaten up the vineyard. The spoil of the poor is in your house. Is in your houses. All the things that the children of God are supposed to enjoy, you have singularly amassed them. You and your wife and your children. And God is saying, I will no longer have it so. I will fight for my people within the house. Verse 15. What mean ye that ye beat my people to pieces? You use pulpits to settle scores. These are means by which these things happen. It's not only money. You use the opportunity that you have the pulpit to rubbish God's people, to deal with them, to destroy them emotionally. And God is saying, this nonsense will not continue in my house. I am going to stand up and deal with it. But I want to tell you, because our God is a merciful God, if you run to him quickly, you will not have to partake of these judgments. That is the truth. God is not happy to destroy us. He's not happy to bring us into the grinding table. He is happy for us to repent so that we will escape all those things, because he's a merciful God. He continues. Say, you grind the face of the poor, said the Lord God of hosts. I jump 16 and the rest of them. You need to read the whole chapter for yourself. Let me read again from verse 25. We are answering the question of why Deborah, why Yahel, warning to leaders. Let me read from 24. And it shall come to pass that instead of sweet smell, there shall be stink, and instead of a girdle, a rent, and instead of a well set ear, badness, and instead of stomach, a garden of sackcloth, nuts, and a bunny instead of beauty. 25. Thy men shall fall by the sword. You can see now. The men will fall by the sword. So God has no choice but to begin to raise women. And the mighty in war, they will all fall by the sword. Verse 26. And against that, the gate of Israel, the gate of the church. He said, the gate of Israel shall lament and mourn. And she, being desolate, shall sit upon the ground. That is a sign of highest level of humiliation. Humiliation will come upon many by the reason of God's judgment, not Satan. God will use the world to whip the church into shape. You may not see it yet. They call you, and it's going to be in form of the press, in form of government and the rest of them. I want to strongly challenge, I want to recommend to leaders, especially those of us who are leading ministries, who are leading churches, please put your books in order. The government will come at you in this decade. They will try to rubbish the church. You need to put yourself together. Put your house in order. You cannot say you have not been told. I am telling you, the press, the public, and the government are coming after the church in this decade. And it is to the intent that the church might be purged. God wants to purge the church. And that is why he's allowing all those things. And it is that he might have the moral right to be able to judge the world. That's why he's starting judgment from his house. The Bible makes us understand in 1 Peter 4, 17 to 19. For the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? 18. And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? 19. Wherefore let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls unto him in well-doing as unto a faithful creator. Those are the ones that God will pour the spirit of Yahel upon. You look at that verse 19 and compare it to what we said in the synopsis of the spirit of Yahel. You will understand that that was actually what she epitomized. That was what she exemplified. She showed forth, she showcased this spirit that we are talking about in verse 19. She was able to bear. She was able to commit the keeping of her soul to God until God came to vindicate her. God is the one that will vindicate. If you go to Isaiah chapter 50, he said, it is the Lord that vindicates us. God is the one that vindicates. We cannot vindicate ourselves. And as many as endure all these things, and we are able to wait for the Lord, they are the ones that the Spirit of Yahweh will come upon, who God will use to bring the church to where it ought to be. Bring it from its knees. After this humiliation, the glory of the church will now be manifest. And I'm sure that is when the beginning of the fulfillment of that scripture will be on earth before our Lord will come. That the knowledge of the glory of the Lord shall cover the earth as the water cover the sea. I'm seeing that happening after this judgment that we are talking about. But I'm praying that your portion will be glory and not judgment. But that prayer cannot be answered until we begin to check ourselves and make proper amendments for whatever way we are guilty of rubbing the face of God's people on the ground, whether we use them for our political reasons or for our self-esteem, or we use them in order for financial gains. We use the people of God as instruments just for our own self-aggrandizement. God is saying, I will no longer suffer it in this decade. And I'm saying here that we need to take heed because God means business. And I pray that the Almighty God will grant us understanding and the grace to take step accordingly in the name of Jesus. God bless you. We shall continue tomorrow by the grace of God. Bye for now.